Hello, my name is Alexey Matveev, and in this video I will show you how to set up monitoring of Atlassian Confluence with Prometheus, Prometheus for Confluence add-on, and Grafana. In this video we will use this tutorial. And first of all, I will provide links for this tutorial in the description for this video. And first of all, we need to create the Docker Compose YAML file. Let's create it. Here it is. In this docker-compose.yaml, we put up two containers, Confluence and Confluence DB. I will use images from Idalco because with these images I can run Confluence with the Postgres database and it's convenient for me. Okay, we created the docker-compose.yaml file. Now we can put this up, Docker Compose up. Okay, we see that our containers are running now. And let's have a look at it in our dashboard. Here's our dashboard. Confluence, yeah, we've got two containers, Confluence DB and Confluence. We can see logs, we can see stats here. Yeah, okay. Now let's wait until it started. Yeah, it started now. Launcher started. It's written there in the logs. Let's go to Confluence and set it up. Our Confluence runs on localhost 8090. Let's go for production installation. We will not install any additional add-ons. Now we need to provide a license for our Confluence. Let's use our own database. We provided parameters for this database in the docker-compose.yaml file. Our hostname is Confluence DB, port 5432. Database name is Confluence. Username is Confluence. And password is secret. Now we can test our connection. It works, success, next. Okay, we will create an example site because later I will put some load on our Confluence and I want to have some data there. Okay. We will manage users and groups within Confluence. Let's create an admin user first. The name is admin, password admin, we'll confirm that the password is admin, next. And now we can go to Confluence. Let's create a space, we will call it test, continue. We will skip tutorial. Page title we will call test 1, publish, and it's done. Now we need to install Prometheus for Confluence add-on. Let's go to manage apps. Okay, now let's go to find new apps. Type here Prometheus and install it. Okay, installing Prometheus exporter for Confluence, correct. Next, let's have a look at the configuration of this app. Go to manage apps. Prometheus, configure, and now let's go to expose metrics. Yeah, you see we've got here metrics, so everything is correct. Everything is set up. Okay, next we have to run Prometheus and Grafana. Again, we will run it in a docker-compose.yaml file. Let's create this file. In this docker-compose.yaml, we will put up four containers, Prometheus, cadvisor to monitor our Docker containers, and node exporter to monitor our host, and Grafana. Okay, we created the file. Okay, next we need to create Prometheus.yaml file. This is the configuration file for Prometheus. In this file, we define two jobs, Prometheus and Confluence. In Prometheus, we will define localhost, cadvisor, and node exporter will take metrics from there. And in Confluence, we define our Confluence instance. We will take metrics also from the Confluence instance. Okay, we created the file. Next, we can put the docker-compose.yaml file up. Let's do that. Yeah, all containers are running. Let's have a look at these containers in our dashboard. Okay, we've got four containers. All of them are green. Everything is correct. Next, what's next? Next, we can set up Grafana. Grafana runs on localhost 3000. Let's open it. Skip. Okay, now we have to set up Prometheus data source. URL for Prometheus is http://prometheus1990. Let's type it here. Done. Now let's save and test. Yeah, everything is good. And now we can create a dashboard. Yeah, we can create a new dashboard, but I will use a JSON file which I prepare it. Here is the link to the file. But this file is already on my local file system. That's why I'll take it from there. Here it is, import, and we've got some graphics here. Yeah, see, so we've got metrics from Confluence, from Node Exporter, and from cadvisor. And now we can already use the tool from Atlassian to put some load on our Confluence instance. First, let's git clone this project. Okay, let's go to terminal and clone it. Done. Next, let's follow this README file to install all requirements for this toolkit. What we've got to do first, let's have a look. First, we need to install a virtual environment. Let's install it. Okay, we're downloading. First, we install virtual environment and we're downloading all required libraries. Let's see what we've got to do next. Next, we've got to create a new virtual environment for our project. Okay. Create it. What's next? Next, we need to activate our virtual environment. Okay, can you see we've got VN here, so our environment is active. And now we have to install requirements for our toolkit. Let's install it. But meanwhile, it's installing. we need to change also the confluence.yaml file. This file contains parameters for our Confluence instance, for our tests, how many users to use by. I will put links to my articles in the description for this video. You can later read my articles and I'll explain there in details about each parameter in this file. Okay, let's open the confluence.yaml file. Okay, here it is. First, we need to change application host name. We will change it to localhost. Okay, HTTP application port is 8090. Login admin. We'll use 5 concurrent users. And let's change it the duration to 1 minute. We don't want our test to take long. So we've configured this file. And now we can already launch this tool. Okay, let's launch it. Let's go to app folder first, then bctconfluence.yaml. Okay, and we've got an error. Why we've got this error? This toolkit uses REST API, and that's why we need to enable REST API in Confluence. By default, REST API is off. Let's go to Manage Apps. Further configuration. Edit. And now we need to mark this remote API option. Save. It's saved. Let's try to run it again. Okay, it's starting now and it's working. Okay, let's go to Grafana and have a look. Yeah, you see we've got CPU time is going up, threads going up. So basically, metrics are going up. It means that our Confluence is under load right now. What we've got to do next, we've got to wait until CPU time goes down. It will mean that our tests are over and we can have a look at the results of the test. Yeah, you see now the CPU time is down. Let's go to our terminal and have a look what's going on there. Okay, we've got here a table with the results, so everything looks correct. If you want to find out more about results, you can read my articles. And that's all in this video. So we set up with you monitoring of Atlassian Confluence with Prometheus for Confluence, add-on, and Grafana. I hope you like this video. See you next time. Bye.